It's summer, and it's been getting hot. I've got this nice little desk fan, which is handy for keeping the office a little bit cooler, but it's not rechargeable and uses a lot of batteries. I've also got a couple of these power banks, which were given out for free at a conference I attended a few years ago. It's time for a bit of a hack. Now, I'm not sure what the actual capacity of the power bank is, but it claims to be 2,200 mAh, so that's not too bad. To take the power bank apart, we just unpeel this front sticker and then undo these screws. You can then just push the contents out the metal tube. Inside, we've got the PCB with the USB connector and an 18650 battery. It's a pretty compact PCB, and after watching a lot of Big Clive teardowns, I was initially concerned that I couldn't see any sign of a charging chip or battery protection circuitry. This little chip is an MP3042A, and initially I struggled to find any information on it, but I was able to find some Chinese data. Fortunately, Google speaks a bit of Chinese, and it's turned into a pretty readable bit of English. It turns out this little IC does everything: battery charging, battery protection, and boosting the battery voltage to 5 volts. It just needs a few passive components. It's amazing how simple power banks actually are, and these ones I've got are quite a few years old. Shoehorning the 18650 cell and charging circuit into the fan was pretty easy. There's plenty of space in the base, and there's even more once the batteries have been removed. I did have to trim a bit of plastic, and there is a small imperceptible bulge once the case is closed. To hook things up, I just removed the battery clips and joined the wires onto an old USB cable that I'd hacked up for a previous project. I could have soldered these wires directly onto the board, but since I had this cable, I thought I would save my eyesight. At some point, I do need to upgrade this hack so that the charging point is a bit more easy to access. At the moment, you need to take the battery cover off to charge it up. The existing PCB does have a power jack, and initially I was thinking of using this to provide power for the charger, but slightly worryingly, the power jack is connected directly to the battery terminals, so I'd need to do a bit of work to make this safe. At that point though, it's probably worth replacing the whole circuit board with a custom one. All in all though, it's quite a nice little mashup of a free power bank and a fan. I get 5 to 6 hours of runtime from the single cell, which is not too bad. It's really worth picking up these free power banks, as they are a great source of components. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.